of in the early morning hours of today to at least one B1 felony with one of the children with which he has, is about to be charged but has not yet. This was a 15-year-old child who reported the offense to law enforcement. The third-degree sexual exploitation of a minor, as you know, is basically a possession of child pornography charge, and we expect that to be raised to a first-degree sexual exploitation of a child. We're not sure yet how many images there will be regarding those particular types of images, but the law enforcement officers have those in their possession. That would be a Class C at least, and a B1. We would be asking for a $2 million bond at this point.
Anything that you want me to know about what the district attorney you requested? Again, you do not have to say anything.
I mean, I don't know exactly what I need to say. I mean, I've done a lot of good work in the school system, and I've made some bad choices.
All right. State and defendant, I've accepted his waiver, informed him of his court date. I'll make the following modifications to the conditions of his pretrial release. Defendant's bond is modified upward to $1 million secured. Should he be in a position to make that bond, he is under an order not to have any contact with any victim or their families, not to be on the school grounds of any school, or not to be in the presence of any minor child under the age of 18 without direct adult supervision. Anything else you want the court to know about it?
No, we would just be asking for no communication with any minor child.
All right. In addition, not to be in the presence of any minor child, nor communicate with any minor child pending further court order. All right, Mr. Kelly, that completes your first appearance. Again, your court date is February 22nd in courtroom 302.